This is a 5.7-inch e-ink display that shows the cover art, song, and artist of whatever song I'm listening to on Spotify. In this video, I am going to show you the design process that I used to make this interesting device, and I'm going to show you how you can make it yourself. The device uses only two parts, a Raspberry Pi Zero 2W and this 5.7-inch e-ink display from Pimaroni. This is the first time that I have built a complete project from the software all the way to modeling an enclosure with Fusion 360. It was a very challenging yet rewarding project, and I am very happy with the end result. Let's take a closer look at the necessary components for this build. The brains of this project is a Raspberry Pi Zero 2W. This is a small and affordable computer that is perfect for this project. In order to use it with the e-ink display, I needed to solder the GPIO headers to the board. Now let's take a look at the star of this project, which is the 5.7-inch 7-color display from Pimaroni. The name of this particular display is the Inky Impression, and it is designed to be used with a Raspberry Pi. As you can see on the back, there is a female GPIO header where we are going to plug in the Raspberry Pi. Additionally, this display features 4 physical buttons on the side, which is a nice addition to add extra functionality to the device. The only other necessary component in this build is a micro USB cable that will be used to power both the Raspberry Pi and the e-ink display. Let's now go ahead and look at the design iteration of the 3D imprinted enclosure. I made several different versions in Fusion 360 before I was fully satisfied with the result. The first design was very basic, but gave a good rough draft for the overall look that I wanted to achieve. You can see in the model that it has 2 parts with cutouts for the display and a logo cutout for airflow and the cable to slot through. Additionally, I added 4 holes in the back to be able to screw the pieces together. I ended up using these really nice brass inserts to be able to screw together the front and the back. I was really happy with the first version, however, there was still a lot of room for improvement. I then went back to the drawing board and decided to make a completely new Fusion 360 project. This time around, I actually imported the Raspberry Pi Zero model, and I even made my own custom model for the e-ink display. Having all of these components in one project made designing the enclosure much easier. I was able to actually design around both the e-ink and the Raspberry Pi to ensure that everything had proper dimensions. There were a few key changes in this design compared to the first. I added a slot on the back to properly route the cable through the back. Additionally, I decided to make this design a snap fit case so no screws were necessary in the build. In order to do that, I added these angled joints in the model. I also added standoffs for the Raspberry Pi to hold it in place in the enclosure. Lastly, I added 4 buttons to the side in case I wanted to use them in future updates. Currently, the buttons aren't used for anything, but I think it would be interesting to add Spotify Media Control in the future. Overall, this second design was much more professional looking and the project was really taking shape. I then decided to make smaller adjustments in the third version of this design. In the second version, there were only 2 snap fit joints, and I wanted to add 2 more to this new design. Additionally, I made the enclosure slightly thicker to improve the overall structural integrity. Lastly, I made minor modifications to the dimensions to improve the tolerances between the enclosure and the e-ink display. Let's now move on to discuss 3D printing and some of the issues that I ran into. The major issue that I kept running into when 3D printing the enclosure was durability. I am relatively new to 3D printing and have only used standard PLA. The first few prints, I used this matte PLA that I had laying around, and I really like how it looked. However, it was very weak, and parts such as the snap fit joints would just break off. I decided to go purchase some PETG because I heard that it is much stronger. Once I switched to using PETG, I was really impressed with the strength of the prints. Not only was the PETG stronger, but it was also more flexible and had more give to it. The only issue that I had with PETG was slight warping of the corners. However, this was easily fixed by adding a brim to the print in Cura and using a glue stick on my print bed. Now I'm going to show how to set up the software on the Raspberry Pi to get it to display the DeSong information. All of the code is open source and is available on my GitHub in the description down below. This code is actually forked from a similar project that I made a few years ago using a RGB matrix to display the cover art. I have a full tutorial on my channel for that project as well, so be sure to check it out. The first step in setting up the software is to flash a microSD card with the Raspberry Pi OS on it. In order to do so, I use the Raspberry Pi Imager software, which will also be linked in the description down below. I always click the settings icon before writing the image to the SD card. This allows me to enable SSH to remotely access my Raspberry Pi and to connect it to my home network. Then I click write and wait for it to finish. Now that the SD card has been imaged, I'm going to plug it into my Raspberry Pi and turn everything on. I can now SSH to the Raspberry Pi using the following command. Now that I am logged in, we are going to modify some settings on the Raspberry Pi so that it can interface with the display. I'm going to change to the root user using sudo su. Now I'm going to use raspi-config in order to bring up the configuration menu. I'm going to select interface options and then SPI, and I'm going to enable that. And then I'm also going to select interface options again. And I'm going to select I2C this time, and I'm going to enable that as well. And then I'm just going to click finish. And that's all the configuration that we have to do. Now I'm going to navigate to my GitHub and copy this command that says wget on the README file. Now I'm going to paste that command into my command prompt. After the script has completed downloading, we need to modify the permissions to allow us to execute it. I use the command chmod plus x and then the script name to make it executable. Now we need to run the script using sudo bash setup.sh. This is going to install necessary packages and libraries, and all we have to do is wait. Once it is done installing, it is going to prompt for our Spotify credentials. In order to complete this project, we need to go to the Spotify Developer Dashboard and create a new app. We will give our app a name and a description. Once completed, we will have the Spotify client credential, which we can copy into our command prompt. Next, we will also need to copy the Spotify client secret. Lastly, we need to add a redirect URI to the Spotify application. For this project, I just use http://localhost/redirect. We then copy that into the command prompt and hit enter. Next, simply enter your Spotify username. This is going to produce a URL that we need to copy into a browser. We need to accept the terms of service, and then it is going to redirect us to another URL. Copy this URL from your browser and paste it to the command prompt. This will create a file named .cache in the current directory and will be used to authenticate with the Spotify API. Then we need to provide the full path to the cache file we just created, and in my case, it will be home/pi/spotify-eink/.cache. That is it for the software setup, and it should now say setup is complete when done. With the software installed, it should now display the cover art of the song we are listening to on Spotify. Overall, I am really happy with how this project turned out, and I am excited to see people create it for themselves. If you enjoyed this video or found it useful, please consider subscribing to the channel. It helps me out a lot.